Yo, what's good YouTube? It's your boy Introspective, and welcome to my top 5 favorite games of 2017. My personal way of celebrating a great resurgence in not only Nintendo, but a plethora of fantastic indie titles, and gaming in general just seem to be elevated this year. Unless you're EA, in which case, you can elevate my dick into your mouth. Anyways, I'm going to be showcasing my 5 favorite titles from 2017. And keep in mind, these aren't necessarily the games I thought were the 5 best overall, just my favorites to play. And I rank them according to that. So, if you don't see your favorite game, or the game you thought was best, it wasn't that I thought it wasn't deserving, it just means I had more fun playing these games, or I didn't even play that game at all. So, without further ado, let's get started. Starting off the list at number 5, we have A Hat in Time developed by Gears for Breakfast. Now, I didn't know what to expect from indie developers this year, after 2016 cursed me with No Man's Sky. But I'm here to report that 2017 was possibly the best year ever for the indie scene moving forward, and it's all thanks to games like this one. A Hat in Time is just so refreshing. There were moments I felt like I was a kid again playing GameCube or N64. It really embraces the concept of enjoying a game through both its charm and gameplay. You can really feel the Mario influence in this game with its mechanics. You're able to do things like wall jump and air dash, but it still has its own feel, and I really love how floaty the mechanics are, while still being really tight and responsive. And hey, for all you smashers out there, you can even tech in this game. There's great humor sprinkled throughout the game, and there's also a variety of hats with unique abilities that allow for different ways to solve things and ultimately play, and you can switch them all with just one button. It's really convenient, and it's a lot of fun. The game also excels at pacing. There's never really a dull moment. There's a mission early on where you get to jump around and use all of your abilities because you have to catch this guy. And it's cool because it's teaching you how to play the game through gameplay, and you're earning a reward for it as opposed to a mindless tutorial at the start that just dumps info on you. And that's something I always appreciate as a gamer, learning on my own through actual gameplay. It's just a fun collectathon with plenty of things to find, the timepieces, yarn to construct more hats, gems, tickets to open up vaults. It's great! I won't say or show much because it's the type of game that should be experienced somewhat blind in my opinion because of its charm, but if you enjoy 3D platforming collectathons, there was really only one that was better in 2017. I think we all know which one that was. Yooka-Laylee. Now, of all the things on this earth, I never expected an Ubisoft-developed game to be on this list, but their strategy-intense crossover with the world of Nintendo was one of the most pleasant surprises I've ever had as a gamer. Mario & Rabbids Kingdom Battle is one of my favorite games I've experienced in a long time. It was in between the releases of Breath of the Wild and Odyssey when I played this, and it did a spectacular job of filling in the space between those two games. I thought it would take some time to grow on me because, you know, reasons, but it was actually the opposite. I was pretty much hooked from the get-go. As a huge fan of strategy games, Kingdom Battle was pretty much my dream. I grew up loving games like Final Fantasy Tactics and the turn-based combat of the older FF games, so this was right up my alley. And the fact that I got to play as Mario characters just made it all that better. The game is beautiful to look at, and in between the battles, some of which took me multiple tries and a lot of time to win, are a variety of fun puzzles and hidden items and areas to discover. There's a variety of weapons for each character, and a skill tree as well, so you can build them how you want as you progress. Each character excels at a different aspect of combat, so it's up to you to find a suitable team for different scenarios. Or, if you're like me, become a master of Peach, because goddamn, I'm not gonna lie. Seeing my video game wife holding a gun made me pretty fucking horny. But in all seriousness, if you're a fan of any type of strategy game or turn-based combat, this is a must-play in my opinion. I understand this game isn't for everyone because not everyone enjoys that, but if you're a fan of that, this game is going to be a masterpiece in your opinion. Definitely check this one out. Coming in at number 3, we have the Game of the Year, Breath of the Wild. Man, it feels good to say a Nintendo title won Game of the Year, doesn't it? Well, not much needs to be said about this game because pretty much everything has already been said. I did a full review of this game on my channel already, so if you want to hear my more in-depth thoughts, feel free to check that out. But this game is just a revolutionary masterpiece. Not only does it show off the future of Zelda, it really shows the potential within the future of gaming as a whole. We're going to look back on this game in 20 years and say, yeah, this was the one that really changed everything. Breath of the Wild is fun, challenging, immersive, heartwarming, epic, and pretty much everything else in between. Congratulations on winning Game of the Year. I couldn't be more satisfied with how this game turned out, and it's definitely going to be a constant source of entertainment throughout the rest of my life. My second favorite game of 2017 has really become my favorite indie game ever made. Sorry, Undertale. And that game is, of course, Cuphead. I've never played a game quite like this one, and it excels in every field. Aesthetically, it's one of the most gorgeous games of the year. The rich, warm look combined with the 1930s style art and the over-the-top character design is what makes Cuphead a memorable game from the get-go. I love boss rush games. My favorite moments of Mega Man were always fighting the robot masters, and Cuphead takes that concept and transforms it into a standalone triumph of tight controls, incredibly difficult challenge, and the will to just keep playing until you win, because you genuinely want to beat this game and say you did it. The music is incredible, it has a classic swing or jazz vibe, and just adds to the whole style the game presents that makes it a completely unique experience. I've played it time and time again already, and I don't intend on pushing it to the side anytime soon. Easily my favorite indie title ever made, Cuphead is an absolute must-play for any gamer, all for the price of just $20. If you haven't played it, please support this gem and go buy it. You will not regret it. Before we get into my favorite title of 2017, I have two games that are worthy of honorable mention. The first is Sonic Mania, which is really just a perfect tribute to classic Sonic that I both loved and respected, and the second is Doki Doki Literature Club. Not necessarily because of the game itself, but because it has provided me with plenty of Rule 34 material for my personal spank bang. And my number one favorite game of 2017 is, drumroll please, it's Odyssey. Is anyone surprised by this? No? Okay. Super Mario Odyssey is, in my opinion, the best platformer of the 21st century so far, and it's the only one I put on par with Banjo-Kazooie. This game oozes innovation, and I don't see how they can possibly make a better Mario game than this one. This is a perfect game in my opinion, and it was my choice for Game of the Year, but of course, with Nintendo taking home the trophy regardless, I can't even be mad. Every single world is incredibly immersive and feels complete, which is saying something considering some kingdoms are much more vast than others. I enjoyed something in every single kingdom, from the races in the Snow Kingdom, to being a fireball, to going to space and being in zero gravity, to just finding any of the 999 moons. This game occupied my entire existence until I 100% finished it, and there hasn't been a game like that for me in a very long time. This game has already cemented itself as legendary, and every single person I know who's played it has absolutely loved it. It's worth buying a Switch alone for this one game. And that, my friends, makes this my favorite and personal best game of 2017. And there you have it, those were my favorite games of 2017, and this year was just so phenomenal for gaming that these five games, being my five personal favorites when there were just so many to name, is actually quite the accomplishment because of the amount of quality that was released over these last 12 months. So I'm super excited to see what comes of 2018 with gaming, especially Nintendo with the Switch leading the way. And thank you guys so much for watching. If you want to support my channel one more time this year, hit that like button or hit that subscribe button if you haven't yet, and leave a comment letting me know what your five favorite games or just personal favorite game of 2017 was. I'd love to hear from you guys one last time this year. Anyways, I just have to gush real quick. Thank you all so much from the bottom of my heart for the success of this channel this year. It's truly been humbling, and I can't believe that I'm in a position that I can just make YouTube videos to entertain you guys and, you know, live off of that and have a life and enjoy my life and do what I love because of your support. So thank you to each and every single one of you who clicks on this channel, to anyone who's even watched 1 minute of one of my videos. I thank you so much because this has really been my dream for a long time, and to see it finally flourishing because of this year, a year where I hit 100,000 subscribers, a year where I became a Twitch partner, which by the way, I will resume streaming on January 1st, 2018, so be on the lookout for that. It's just an honor and a privilege, and there's really nothing else I can say except for thank you, and I hope to continue entertaining and inspiring you guys, much like you all inspired me this year in 2018. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you guys on January 1st for a new video and streaming, and it's going to be great. Have a great new year. I hope you had a great holiday. Take care. Deuces.
And all my people that's drug dealing just to get by, stack your money till it gets sky high. We weren't supposed to make it past 25. Joke's on.